Hello friends, we'll discuss multi-time frame analysis in this video. I believe it is very important for picking the stocks. I'll explain you a method of doing it in a very simple way. Though it is on point and figure charts, but you don't really need to know much about P&F for it. When we analyze a chart on different time frames, we try to ensure that all time frames are in sync. So if long term, medium term, etc. time frame are in indicating the same trend, then we trade short term chart. So for example, long term is quarterly, medium term is weekly, intermediate is monthly, and short term is daily time frame. Okay, so we can divide it in two parts: short term, which is a trading time frame, and others are higher time frame. So short term is a trading time frame. I'll place trades on daily time frame in that case, and rest of the time frames are for analysis. So I'll analyze different time frames but take trades based on the formation of short term time frame. So for example, if I'm trading a daily time frame chart, I will take a trade based on daily time frame formations, but I will check if weekly, monthly, etc. time frames are also in uptrend. So it is like this. This is short term time frame. Here we will take our trading decisions based on the formations, and these are for the references. We are trying to check whether they are also in sync. So if I'm buying, I would like to have uptrend in all time frames. Now these things can be simplified. Look at this image. It is a swing breakout pattern, meaning previous high is crossed. It is called as a double top buy formation in point and figure, which gets triggered here. So this is a bullish pattern. We'll score it 2. It is a very bullish scenario. Price is going up and it is above previous swing high. Opposite of it is bearish swing breakout. Price is below previous low. It is known as double bottom sell signal in point and figure. It is very bearish, so score is minus 2. This is a pattern of retracement. Price is correcting after a bullish breakout but haven't generated bearish breakout. So it is a semi-bullish pattern and the score is 1. Now this is a bearish breakout pattern followed by retracement. It has not given a bullish breakout, so it is a semi-bearish pattern and score is minus 1. This is a pattern of consolidation. Not bullish, not bearish. So it is a neutral pattern. So score is 0. So if you spend time on this, you will realize that these are the only possibilities on any given chart and time frame. So we have taken all possible price structures into account and scored the chart. Now we can score the patterns on different time frames. So I'm going to matrix, point and figure matrix. Now look at this table. Just by reading the score, you can know whether the pattern is bullish, bearish, or semi-bullish, semi-bearish, or neutral. And these are the different time frames. This is short term, medium term, intermediate, long term. And this is total of all. So when you look at the total score, you can get to know about the patterns on different time frames. So for example, if score is 8, that means it is bullish on all time frames, and when score is minus 8, that means it is bearish on all time frames. Now if I want to look for stocks which are bullish on higher time frames and correcting in short term or my trading time frame, so I want the score of 2 on higher time frames and score of 1 on my trading time frame. So that means the total score will be 7. Right, so I can look for patterns with score of plus 7 and minus 7 and trade the next breakout. If the stop loss of breakout pattern is affordable, it is a tradable setup. Let me take to that image again. See, here it will be very interesting if higher time frames are bullish and price is correcting in a short term. So next breakout is tradable. It will be a breakout in sync with higher time frames. So this is what score 7 will show you for the bullish trades and minus 7 for bearish trades. But since this is objective, software can do the work for you. So if you go to smart scanners and PNDF level picker, select the group and scan. It will analyze the stock on multiple time frames and the find the stocks in momentum and find if it is in a corrective mode and higher time frames are in sync and if stop loss is affordable for the next follow through breakout. So this is type bullish or bearish, and this is DTB bullish level, which is showing a next bullish breakout level. So stock can be bought about that. And if it is bought, then this becomes the double bottom sell exit level or a bearish swing breakout level. So that can be a stop loss. Same way, this is a DBS bearish level, which is a bearish breakout level. And this is the exit level, which becomes stop loss for that bearish trade. So I hope you have understood the process we are following in this method. You can run this scanner on daily basis on any group of stocks. Please write us at info@definance.com in case of queries or feedback. Thank you for watching this video.